be telling the story, or should I say I will be retelling the story of Rip Van Winkle. I just want to apologize beforehand if I leave anything out or miss anything. So, let's get to the story. Long ago in colonial America, before the Revolutionary War, at the foot of the Catskill Mountain in New York, there lived, in a small village, a guy named Rip Van Winkle. And he was kind of just your average Joe, you know. And one autumn day, to get away from the nagging of his wife, he decides to take a walk. So he tells his son and daughter, hey, you know, I'm going out to walk in the woods. He takes his dog Wolf with him. And as he's out walking, he notices this guy that's dressed up like, he's got a very antique-looking Dutch clothes. And the guy's yelling at him, and he's like, hey, Rip Van Winkle, hey, Rip Van Winkle. And Rip is kind of shocked because he doesn't recognize the guy. He doesn't know the guy, but he goes over to the guy anyway. And the dude's like, hey, I'm carrying this keg up this mountain. Can you give me a hand? And so Rip's like, yeah, sure, no problem. I'll be more than willing to. So he helps this guy carry this keg up this mountain, and they come to a tree hollow, and they go in, and there's all these other guys that are very similar to this guy, all, you know, dressed in Dutch clothing. So they sit down and have a drink out of the liquor from this keg, and they talk and have a good old time and drink, and eventually Rip passes out. He wakes up, finds that he's got a beard a foot long, and his hair's gray, and he's a bit confused because he can't find his dog, and so he decides he's going to head on back to his village. As he arrives at the village, it looks different, and it looks bigger, and he doesn't really recognize anybody. And one of the villagers comes up to him, and they're like, and the dude's like, who'd you vote for? Rip's like, you know, I'm a loyal subject of King George III. That really strikes a chord with a lot of the villagers. They kind of start to crowd around him, and they're yelling and calling him names. Then this one old lady makes her way through the crowd, and she recognizes him, and she's like, Rip, is that you? We thought you were lost. She explains to Rip that he's been disappeared for over 20 years, and that there's been a war, the Revolutionary War, and America fought and won its independence from England. And she takes him to the local tavern, and where there used to be a fine drawing sketch of King George III, now there's a fine drawing sketch of George Washington. Needless to say, Rip is very confused. And he's even more confused to find out there's another guy in town named Rip Van Winkle. It's his son, grown up, a man now. And you know, he finds out that his wife's dead and his house has been sold, so his daughter agrees to take him in. And, you know, aged and confused, Rip just goes right back on to living life like he did. So that's more or less the gist of the story. It's believed by the townspeople, the villagers, that Rip encountered the crew of the, what is it? Oh, I can't remember the name of the ship. I keep wanting to say it's the Full Moon, but I could be wrong. And the captain's name was Henry, and apparently this ship disappeared, and so the villagers, you know, assumed that Rip had encountered the spirits of this crew, and they had somehow transported him forward in time, or like kept him in a deep sleep for that amount of time. Anyways, it's a very interesting tale. If you've heard it, you know, if you've heard it before, let me know down in the comment section below. If there's something I missed, let me know in the comment section down below. If you like the story, please give the video a like. If you enjoy this kind of content, please subscribe to the channel and share. Help the channel grow. And if you have any ideas for stories that you'd like to hear, let me know. And that'll be